Today we've got a little Jack Crevalle catch and cook video. It didn't start out becoming a catch and cook video, but as you'll see, when the footage rolls, we had a little incident with our first Jack. He wasn't gonna make it, and my son wants to eat pretty much everything he catches. Now, I do know that they eat Jack Crevalle pretty much everywhere else in the world. I've tried it personally once before. I just filleted it and cooked it, and it was definitely edible, but I didn't much care for it. But this time I decided give it a little better chance, cut the bloodline out, cut the bones out, do it right. Now, that being said, if you search around on the internet for recipes or ways to cook Jack Crevalle, you'll find a lot of things like soaking it in a salt bath 10 different times and soaking it in milk for 27 days, or buried in a hole in the ground on a full moon and come back 6 months later. All kinds of recipes that are real involved. I'm not interested in that because I'm not going to eat a fish on any regular basis that requires a whole lot of prep. So anyway, you see the video, start out catching a few fish. Then we tried two different ways. I was originally going to do three. I was going to do fish cakes as the third, but as you'll hear in the video, my son really protested fish cakes. He's a bit of a purist. He likes to have it just cooked in a pan or on the grill. Doesn't like batter, doesn't like fish cakes, any of that. So anyway, hope y'all enjoy, and there's some pretty surprising results. Thanks for joining us. What? Okay. All right. I need your bait bucket. I need to put water in the bucket. Get the empty bucket. Just fill it about halfway. That's plenty. Didn't get a lot, but it was a blind cast, so two mullets, not bad. All right, put them in the bucket.
I can't. Too funny.
You can get them. This bucket. The other one jumped out. All right, watch them so they don't jump out. Okay, bud. Okay.
Did you catch any?
I don't think so. But I got those two.
What?
I don't think so, but I got those two good ones in the bucket. Oh, I did get some. Moharas.
Small ones? I put all of them in.
Yep. So I want to see if there's a fish on. Come reel it in.
Okay. Is it moving a lot?
A little bit. The tip up.
Oh my god, there's something heavy on it. There's something heavy. You got that fish.
What'd you get? A puffer.
Put him in the bucket.
You got a puffer.
Bucket. So when he dies, he might die, but I don't know if he might die or not. I'm not gonna play the a pufferfish though. Because he might bite me still when they die.
We're not gonna let him die.
This just touched the stick and got stuck. It touched it.
Alright. Pick it up.
Big and fatter.
He's popping up.
Sometimes okay. You catch popping.
Keep the.
Put them in the bucket.
Try to keep your line out of the bushes. Okay, go let the puffer go. Go let that puffer go. Just put your hands underneath him. Put your hands underneath him and scoop him up. He can't bite you if you put your hands under him.
He's gonna bite. This last time he bit me, one of them bit me. So you can put him in this bucket.
You want to look at him for a little bit? Okay. Gotta let him go soon though, okay? Can't keep those. Yep, you're not allowed to keep them here.
What does it mean when...
Yep. We got fish on, buddy. You want a reel?
Yeah.
Hey, come here.
Right here.
My big catfish.
A big.
Okay,
super.
Reel. See, are you swimming? Careful.
Oh, God.
Oh, what? Nope, it's a jack.
I can't.
Little jack.
Can I see it? Where is he?
Come on.
Can't.
All right, let's bring him this way. Let's bring him this way. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Big shack. Small. You got a big shack.
Yeah, he's pretty small.
Can you take a picture so Grandma can see him in the picture?
Watch out. Buddy, this line will cut you. Watch out.
Can we take a picture so we can show it to Grandma? And
yep.
Then you can send it to
You can
Grandma.
Take a picture. You can take a picture.
You
Hold on.
Send it to Grandma.
Hold on.
He's big. He's bigger than the other one we got at that beach.
That's true. He is bigger than the little one you got at the beach.
Look at the picture of everybody.
Okay.
Did he cut you?
No, he doesn't want to cut us. Uh-oh. He
what?
Yeah.
What did he eat?
Our hook. Oh, man. Should have brought my hook tool.
Walk your tail. Get his tail. I want his tail right over there.
I don't think he's going to survive this ordeal. Well,
why's he bleeding?
Because he's got a hook inside him.
We should take a picture.
Okay.
And then you can send it to Grandma. You carry it. I don't want to touch that bloody guy.
Well, then why do you want a picture?
He's too bloody for me to touch him. Send it to Grandma. Let me put him in the water.
You might have to revive him a little bit because he got that hook.
There he goes!
No, he's going the wrong way.
Let me get him. I can get him. Can I put him in the water? Can I bring him really deep? I'm gonna bring him really deep. I'll bring him really deep.
I did. I got it, buddy. He's coming back. That hook's messing him up.
I guess we have to eat him.
Keep the tip up. Reel, reel, reel. All right, let's wait out there a little bit. And keep them from getting in the trees, in the mangroves. Head this way. Come on. Come on. Come on. Get him out of the mangroves. You almost took us into the mangroves, bud. What'd you think we got? Let's see. Another jack? Yep.
What? Is it a big one?
Woo!
Bring him over here so we can... Oh, we gotta put the other one! Let's put them with the other one, too. Okay. We got two fish to eat.
Oh,
look, like you can make that one in two.
You're going to have to show people how to eat these things.
You can put that one as a cake.
Oh, man.
Smushed up fish tank. That one cannot be a cake. This one can be a cake if you want.
Oh, you're saying you don't want him to be fish cakes?
This one.
This you want to eat him the way he is?
This one can be a rubber fish cake, and that one can be for you to put on your fish cake.
That's a pretty nice size one, huh?
The one in here, you can put on your fish tank.
All right. You really want to eat them?
The
All right.
One there already. I'm gonna put them in.
You gotta clear our stuff off of there.
We're gonna. Any fish we get, if we get a bunch of these, we're gonna put them in there. He's like the other one. He's big.
Yep.
Can I play with the other one?
No.
But that one can be for you to put on the fish tank. But the wide one can be a rubber one. You can have the freezed up one on your cake. Okay.
I think we got another jack. Whoa. All right. He's going for a run. Oh, got back to the coast. Now the mangroves. Another one.
And eat it. So everybody can have a fish to eat. Any kind of geese we get. Ooh. If we get a bunch of geese, I'm gonna put them in there.
I know, buddy. You want to keep everything. All right.
You want to keep all the geese.
You want to reel it? Let that guy go. Come on, Ryan. You want to reel this one? Hey, we got a fish on while you're playing with bait. You want to reel?
Yeah.
All right, we got to come walk out so we keep him away from the mangroves. All right, can you reel? There you go, bud. Can you hold it by yourself or do you need me to hold it?
I need you to hold it.
Okay. All right, let's walk towards him a little bit because we got to make sure we can pull him away. Keep reeling. Got to make sure we can pull him away from those mangroves. Keep reeling. You got it? Reel faster. All right. Keep reeling.
It's not coming.
All right, do you need me to help you?
Yeah.
Okay. Ow. Yeah, feels like another jack. Okay, buddy, if there's another jack, we're letting him go, okay? Away from the mangroves. Come on. Stay out of the mangroves. There we go. There he is. Oh, yeah, pulling down. Ooh, we got some weeds on here, I think. Yeah, another jack. Okay, buddy, I need the pliers.
What?
Pliers. They're on the tackle box. Pliers. Tackle box. Please. Yes. Oh no. This one need a hook too. These guys really want to steal my hooks.
That guy's still alive.
I know. All right, push him in the water. Still got bait. He's not real happy, but he's alive.
These fillets have been soaking in an ice water bath. So I'm just taking them all out, cutting them into smaller pieces to cook, and drying them off. We did pretty small pieces this time just because we're doing a really basic recipe. Just a little bit of flour and blackening seasoning. I make fish this way for my son a lot because he really likes it that way. He doesn't like heavy batters or anything like that. So just a little flour and a little seasoning helps soak up some of that butter or oil flavor too when you cook it. Simple, it's quick, and my son likes it. So that's how I'm doing it for this. So I had a piece here that I had missed the skin on. I didn't film cleaning these because it was starting to get dark out and it was drizzling on me a little bit, but pretty typical for filleting any fish. They do have some bones and they do have a pretty heavy bloodline, so I cut all that out. Just cooking it here in a pan and some butter. All I do when I cook fish in a pan is just watch until it's cooked a little more than halfway through. You can tell when the flesh starts to turn more opaque. Once it's cooked a little more than halfway through, I just flip it over and leave it for a minute or two on the other side and pull it off. The worst thing you can do with fish is overcook it. So it really doesn't take long, thin fillets like this. This whole process took a few minutes.
Ryan, you've already eaten some fish?
Where's my fish?
On the table.
Is there bones in them?
Shouldn't be. I think I got them all. Alright. Sit over here with your cup. Sit over here. With the crazy monster plate. Okay.
Grab a piece.
All right, you can take it. Use your napkin. Don't wipe it on your shirt.
For grandma?
Well, just put it on your own plate. Just put it on your own plate. Just put it on your own plate.
And then one me.
All right. Use your napkin. Want some lemon?
Actually,
Ryan, you can't keep touching them.
I'll get down to grandpa.
Yep.
I need more lemon.
All right, Grandpa, we're going to do a taste test. See what you think. We got some more left, so I'm going to try it different ways tomorrow.
Done. I got two.
Well, hold on. Finish what you have first. Use your fork. What do you think?
Good.
It's good?
Mm. Are these your favorite?
No, they're not my favorite. I've only had it once before.
They have to be your favorite if you like.
First time I tried it, I didn't cut all the bloodline out. I just wanted to know what it tasted like. This time I knew what it tasted like, so I cut the bloodline out. Remember all that dark red stuff I was cutting off?
Yeah.
Yeah, that meat's a little stronger flavored. I didn't cook a bunch of it, just, you know. Know how it would go.
You're the best.
I'm so glad you like it. Before he even took a bite, he was trying to claim two pieces. I was like, oh, just try it. It's good. It was a lot of work to clean.
Yeah, it looked like it was.
We both got eaten.
You think?
Good.
Yeah.
We both got eaten.
Good.
It's a surprisingly small amount of meat you end up with from those big fish.
Yeah.
I was cutting out anything with bones because I didn't want to risk anyone getting a bone, and then cutting out the bloodline. My first experience with this was not awesome, so I really was aggressive cutting out the bloodline.
Eat your fish, right, Paul?
A lot of fish, like bluefish and mackerel.
You got a fish to eat.
A lot of people.
Right there.
Well, and I've gotten so I usually eat the skin. I just get it crispy.
I usually do too, but I, you know, I.
Dad won't eat it like I do. I
kind of wanted to give this the best chance at being good, you know? Cut off the skin, cut off the bloodline, cut out the bones. It's definitely much less white than a lot of fish are.
Yeah, it's got kind of gray color.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Good job, Ryan.
If I really want a fish, that's all I caught, I'd definitely eat it again.
Did you cook the head for dinner?
No, I didn't cook the head. You can cook the head next time.
What the head?
In a bag.
You're saving some of it?
Yep.
To eat at our house?
So Ryan's first jack that he caught, he used for bait to catch a spinner shark. Remember?
It's small one.
Yeah, it was a little small one. He uses bait to
catch spinner sharks. We'll be at a beach this time.
Yeah, is it fun fishing from the beach? Did you get any fish in your mouth?
And Ryan's second jack, he ate. Let's go.
But when you and the shark is bait, he got a bunch of spinner sharks, but
it's kind of
the other one
firm ate texture his, and more flavor
ate
than
the
a lot.
Fish. Tail off, and then the head was only
actually he ate the head off first. You're talking about the jack we used for bait? Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the shark ate the head first, and then he came back and ate the tail.
Is he still on? A snook the first cast. Is he still on, Ryan? Keep your rod up. Rod up. He's still on? Keep the rod up. Yeah. What'd you get?
It has a lot of
fish. Oh, you got a little jack. That's actually good bait.
I don't want all of them go.
That's good bait.
That's what's left of our jack after a big hit. Yeah.
Yeah, Ryan's first jack, he caught a little jack crevalle about that big at the beach on Saturday, and we threw it out on a big surf rod and caught a spinner shark. We didn't get it all the way in. It was spinning like crazy and it cut the mono. And then his second jack he's eating.
Right now?
This is a jack crevalle.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I caught this for you.
Oh, thank
I
you.
I got it for a grandpa.
I thought you liked fish. Oops.
I'm just one.
Sorry, Mom. Okay. Yeah, that turned out to be right. Nope.
I can get him some paper towels.
So what do you think, Dad? For something everyone calls a trash fish?
Yeah, something they call a trash fish. It's surprising.
Everywhere else in the world they eat them.
Okay, so this is the next day, trying a second recipe. My son was not with me on this day, so we did beer battered jack. Since he doesn't like fried fish, I cooked it that way while he wasn't there. We did have some extra people here to taste test this one though. Now, in the two pans here, the two Tupperware, one is just rice flour, and the other is going to be a mixture of rice flour and regular flour. The rice flour you dust onto the fish first, and then the mixture is about one part rice flour to three parts regular flour, and that's going to be the batter that is on the outside. The rice flour serves to make your beer battered fish really crispy, and it also makes it stay crispy for longer. If you just use regular flour, it'll be great when it first comes out, but it won't be quite as crispy and it won't stay crispy for as long. But by adding that rice flour, it really adds to the crunch. I highly recommend it if you haven't done it that way before. So here I'm just mixing up that batter, and I don't add the beer, which makes it wet, until the last possible minute, because you want it to stay as cold as possible to get the best results. Okay, so here I'm just dusting all of the fish fillets in the rice flour. And this, the tub is just plain rice flour. So I put in there a few of there at a time, shake it up, pull them out, put them on the plate, and these are all ready to be dipped. I'm prepping all of them in advance. Now I'm pouring the beer in straight out of the fridge. For this recipe, I use about 2/3 to 3/4 of a bottle, and there's about, I think, a cup of flour is total, a quarter cup of rice, and then 3/4 of a cup of regular flour to, I don't know, like 8 ounces of beer. Doesn't have to be all that exact. And stirring it up till it's pretty well mixed. You don't want to overstir anything that has flour in it. It affects the gluten in flour and makes it chemically change, so things don't taste right. That's why store-bought cookies don't taste as good as homemade. They're all overstirred. The batter's overstirred. So you stir it just enough to get it all mixed. Don't worry about all the tiny little lumps. Those are fine. And then tossing them in the frying pan or in the pot. The first batch, the oil was a little too hot, so I had to back off the temperature. They were cooking too fast and getting too dark. Really only takes 2 or 3 minutes for them to finish. They're fairly thin fillets, so don't leave them in there for too long. And they get a nice golden color, and they are cooked all the way through, and that beer and baking powder really makes it puff up nicely, and the rice flour makes it really crispy. And thank you to the wonderful magic of hot peanut oil. Here we have some nice puffy golden beer battered jack.
Thank you, Daddy.
All right. Very curious to see how the fish is. Hopefully it's all done all the way. I had trouble getting the oil temperature right. So this is, Dad, so you know, anyone else knows, this is like Bang Bang shrimp sauce, and that's traditional pink seafood sauce.
And this is butter.
Nuts.
Correct.
Butter. Yeah.
You got it. Thank
you. How are your nuggets?
Good.
You want to try any fish?
It's really good.
Ryan caught them.
Yeah, Ryan caught this fish out of the river or ocean.
River.
No, I've been in the river.
How is it?
Really good.
Good?
Mm-hmm. It's really good, Bubba. You want to try some?
No, thank you.
How about you take the tiniest little bite and you tell me?
The batter is amazing.
Hold on.
Okay.
Just the crispy part?
It's really crispy and crunchy.
It's delicious.
Fresh.
My favorite kind of batter on a fish.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
Not bad.
Would you like a little piece? Want me to get you a little one?
No, I want a big piece. The whole thing.
How about you start with this and then you make a decision after
that's
this,
good.
Okay?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's really good.
Now I know it.
Sorry, Ron, I missed that.
Mm. You might not have eaten it because he rips batter off.
Oh, that's stuff. Right. That's those? Right. He
doesn't like fried mm-hmm. stuff. I mean, he likes nuggets, but he peels any chunky batter off.
Ryan's that's dad right. made all this. Is it hot? Okay, just give it a minute.
And
you need to
try the fish. It's really good.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Really good.
There was more than I thought. Like once I saw it all puffed up with batter, I was like, oh boy, this is a lot of fish.
Yay! Thank you.
Yep, two hands and then put it back down.
I should have saved some, but I was kind of too deep at that point.
We'll just have to keep eating.
That's the lobster, Mom? Dad.
Yes, Kitty.
Does that come
feel good
to you?
It come out okay?
No.
It's peachy keen.
Peachy keen?
Not too chewy or anything?
I got you a tiny little taste of lobster, okay? It's really good.
What do you think? Pretty tasty.
Not bad.
Not bad.
Would you like the fish or the lobster?
Fish.
Mm-hmm. You heard it here, folks. He likes fish.
The fish is excellent.
Jack, no less.
Which sauce do you like better?
I haven't tried that one yet.
I haven't tried either of them yet.
I mean, I know you know what this tastes like, but if I haven't had it on fish.
This is the Bang Bang,
Bang, Bang.
One?
Yep. Makes good beer battered fish. Thank Dad.
Fish and ducks.
Well, so far both ways, everybody was happy with it.
How'd you make it last night? Pan fried?
Yeah, blackening, seasoning,
the
way I usually
ooh,
do it for Ryan.
I never saw this kind before. I
just wanted to try it like the super easy way first.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm gonna go in the wood.
Frankly, fish would have to be pretty terrible to not be good beer battered.
Yeah.
Jump.
Same way with fish cakes. I was originally gonna do fish cakes, but I just decided. Since we had this lobster to cook too, I was like, oh, that's too many things to do at once.
Mm-hmm.
No one's sure how long it would keep. You want to try any of the Bang Bang sauce, Dad, or can you go with your lobster there? Does he like Bang Bang shrimp? Do you like
Bang Bang
shrimp?
He likes Bang Bang shrimp. Like Bang Bang shrimp, it's a little sweet. So this one is like a pink seafood sauce, horseradish.
Like that.
Mm-hmm.
I think you would like that better for the fish. But you can try this if you want.
This is good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't. What are you doing? I didn't make any tartar sauce because I don't eat tartar sauce. Do you eat tartar sauce, Dad?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I figured.
He prefers cocktail sauce, though.
I hope that Clay goes lobster diving again.
Yeah.
Michelle said they still had some in their freezer.
Was this all we have?
We have four more.
Oh, wow.
Jumping in the mud.
We have four more.
Okay. Do you want another little bite of lobster?
I think I left it in a minute or two too long, but the flavor's good, so. It's hard to know when it's good for us, isn't it?
Yeah, and I made the opposite mistake last time I did home. Daddy's like, this isn't cooked. I was like, I was trying not to overcook them.
Whoa. I set it for like the timer for like 9 minutes and looked, and they were a little translucent still in places. But then,
yeah,
too many minutes passed before I remembered to grab them out.
It is facing me.
Why?
I don't know.
Because that's the only place to put it. Are you okay with that?
It's done now.
I mean, I can edit it out. It's just literally the only place to set it down. It's not on the table.
I would really be just a quick commentary. Eli, do you want another bite of this?
No. It's lobster, you said.
I know. It's really good. Do you want another bite?
No.
Before I finish it, because I'm about to eat it all.
No.
Okay.
That doesn't look good.
But you tasted it and you said it was good.
Not bad.
So we've had a 3-day seafood fest.
No. Right.
It's pretty awesome. We haven't had oysters yet. My neighbors mentioned they were going to have an oyster.